Hi Stampers, today we'll be making this very cute easel card. And this is flat, and this is how it will look popped up. So let's get started. You'll need a piece of 4 1/4 by 4 1/4. Let me get a piece of white paper under here. 4 1/4 by 4 1/4, and 4 1/4 by 8 1/2. We are scoring it at 4 1/4 and 6 3/8. Get one that I didn't mess up. There we go. So it's 4 1/4 and 6 3/8. To make the actual easel card, you will fold your paper on the scores, and you fold it in half, and you fold this in to the center so it looks like a little tent. Then you'll lay it flat, and we're going to use the tear tape, and we're going to put this on in 3 rows just on the bottom. And I'm putting this right on the score line. One of the things that I found works very well to remove the liner from the tear tape is taking it, instead of from the end, from the center and the bottom of it, not the top. The bottom seems to work the best, and just pull it off. And if you have any extra, just push it toward the center, like so. There we go. Next, we're going to take our 4 1/4 by 4 1/4 piece, and we're going to lay it flat on this whole sheet. So we found that if you start on the untaped end, line it up and push down, then it comes out even. And this is how we get our, let's see here, our little easel. Now we can decorate it. Not liking these rough edges here. Okay, now we can decorate it. I'm using mint macaron and the botanical paper, and I've already started decorating it so that it won't be so, this video won't take so long. So it's just 4 by 4, 3 3/4 by 3 3/4, a doily cut in half, and this is the front of our card. So we'll just tape that on. And when you put the one part on, you want to make sure that it lifts up this way so that this is what it will look like. You still have your little tent. Okay. And for the base of it, it's just 2 by 4. And I already put the other half of the doily on there. We'll use some dimensionals to pop this up, and then that prevents it from moving forward when it's all put together. And I'm using 6 halves, otherwise you could just use 3 full ones, like so. Okay, and again, we're just going to put this like, well, we'll move it out of the way, and this will line up with this so it'll look like that. So we put a little bit of an eighth of an inch border, and then when this sits on there, it stops it so that it'll lay nicely. The next part of the decorating is, we could do top or bottom, it doesn't really matter. I have the teapot already taken out and or cut out, and I use the nice cuppa framelits, and in this particular, for this card, we're using the heart, the teapot, the small cup, and the spoon. So we use quite a few pieces in there. Oh, and the tea bag die. Let's see here. So before we put that teapot on, we have to put the little tea bag together. So I just want to show you, this is kind of funny actually. These are my attempts of stamping the little tea bag after I cut them out. I cut them out first and then tried stamping. And you can see that I didn't quite hit the mark, and I tried stamping it on top of the die, or on top of the stamp, as well as stamping down onto it. So I would suggest that with this particular one, you may want to just stamp it and cut it out by hand, or use your frame lid. But it's sort of a funny, hard one to do. So since this thing is so bad, we will just cut out the best one. Yeah, this one's pretty good. We're just going to cut it so it's a little more even. And that will work fine. But just wanted to show you that we demonstrators mess up too. So we have our little tea bag, and I have a piece of black and white baker's twine. So what I'm going to do is take a dimensional and turn it over, put the string down, just set it there, put the dimensional over it, and then we can put it right on our teapot. I suppose I should put the flour on first, but I'll put the flour on first. Okay, so we'll just put a little adhesive on here. And this flour is from the botanicals dyes. Okay, so I'm just setting it right there. Now we can put our tea bag in. And I just set that like so. Bring the string around, and you can just, I like to leave a little bit of a, thing here, a little bit of a gap, and we'll just use a glue dot to keep that down. Like so. It's probably the putziest part of it. All right, now we can put it on our card, and we're just going to set it right there. And then we have our top of our teapot, like so. I've already stamped the sentiment, and that is from the Nice Cup of Stamp Set. And I'll show you that. It's right here. And we're using your Terrific, and here's the little tea bag. And we'll pop that up as well. Oops, pops. Okay, two pop dots for that. And I just use a small oval to punch it out. And then for the bottom part, we're going to put the cup. Again, I've already put the little flower on there. And we'll just set it right here. And for the spoon, probably my favorite part of it, which is sort of silly, but it's just so cute. I'm taking the mat, and this is just in the silver foil, and then I will take a stylus, and this is just so that it's not so flat, and you just go in a circular motion, and then it makes it look more like a spoon, a real spoon. And you just keep going in a circle, and you can see that it's just a little bit more raised. And then I just kind of move it around. Then for the handle, I take my thumb and just give it a little bit of a bend. And I try not to bend it like somebody put it in the ice cream thing and it bent the spoon to heck. So we'll just... And so it just looks a little bit more like a spoon. Then I will take a glue dot, one for the base. Not cooperating here. One for the base, and I'm taking one for the handle, but I'm rolling it, so you'll just grab it and pull it towards you, and it makes a little bit of a roll. Not sure if you can see that or not. And that goes for the handle. You can kind of see it there. And then we will just set that on the card. And that's it. It goes together very easily, and it's just such a nice look that someone could put on their table or on their desk. And again, it just folds down and comes up. Oh, I forgot one little thing here. I do have a little heart that I have some glue, and this would be the steam, like that. And there you go. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.